The cables that are made in this room, this is what we call our gold standard. This is our worldwide headquarters. This is our main production room for all of our high-end cables, all of our mid-range cables. Everything that's made in this room, we mimic. So we make the same exact cables in the Netherlands. We have a facility there that looks exactly like this. The room's the same, the workstations are the same, the hand tools are the same. Everything that we have in this room, we have mimicked in the Netherlands. So over in China, same thing. And any of our factories that makes our cables, it starts here. So we look at it first, we make samples, we send it to them, and then they have to copy it. So if you opened up the inside of the cable, I shouldn't be able to tell if it was made in this room, or the Netherlands, or in Asia. We've even gone to the extent to design our own 3.5 mini connector, and this actually has our Cold-Weld technology inside it. So this is our Cold-Weld system. The tooling that you see, these are 2-ton arbor presses. So you can have 2 tons of force just by pulling this. We've developed all the tooling for all of this based on our connectors. These are all hand-designed, handmade tooling for our connectors. What he's using there is actually copper paste. And we put that on any of the cables that are copper. If the cable is actually silver, we use a silver paste. What RSDale has done is he's already prepped the cable. So you have the two negative conductors, you have the positive conductor, which is going to be the center pin. He'll stick the center pin on the conductor itself. So we actually bend that conductor at a 90 degree angle, and what that does is allows the conductor not to move inside that air tube. Otherwise, it'll move inside the air tube. So the whole piece fits into the fixture. And then in just the pull of his arm, basically what has just happened, if you're familiar with forging, he's basically forged the pin itself and the conductor into one piece. So there's no solder, no heat. It's all done cold, like that, and it fuses those pieces together. That's the shell he's putting on right there. That's what we call the drain wire. So he's gonna stick that in the fixture. He's gonna crimp that down. So now he's completed the process. He has both of these shells plus the center pin. Now if you look at that from this direction, it looks like a typical RCA plug. Once it's all put together, he'll then eventually cut the extra wires off, slide the barrel on, and then you have a finished connector. So this is Redwood, one of our higher end speaker cables. It's a pretty complicated cable. He's already taken out a lot of the filler that's inside there. He's gotten into the inside. He's put the heat shrink down in here, which separates some of the different layers of foil and carbon loaded material. He's ready now to put on what we call our Dbs connection. These cables take an hour and 45 minutes to terminate one pair of cable. So from when he starts till he finishes, it's an hour and 45 minutes. There's over 50 bits and pieces that goes into assembling just this one cable. It's really important what he's doing and the different layers of heat shrink that are in here. These conductors here, the black ones, are what we call carbon loaded. So they have carbon actually in the jacket, and that acts as a conductor. Down inside here, we have foil, we have more carbon, and again, those different elements cannot touch this, nor can they touch any of the conductors in the red. So it's very important that he insulates all of those items while he's manufacturing it. So the connectors he's doing right there, those are our 1000 series connectors. It's made out of what we call red copper. It's a very special copper. It's not easy to machine. This connector is 100% billet, so it's machined from bar stock and then stamped into the shape at the end. Then we plate it with pure silver. The reason it's so shiny, normally if you plate silver like we do, we plate our silver directly onto the copper, so there's nothing underneath it. To get it that shiny, we have to plate very, very thick with a process that we call hanging silver. And by doing so, you can get a much shinier finish, a much smoother finish. The reason we use silver, it's the best conductor you can get. So most people think gold is the standard. When it comes to audio connectors, absolutely not. Silver is a much better conductor. The termination technique that's that is also a cold weld. So these two little screws that are right here actually are putting pressure on those conductors. Very similar to what we did over on the press.